Hello and welcome to Nation Innovation. So today we are going to study about the UART module using the concept of FSM. I hope all have seen the video which we have provided for the FSM, and we will see the UART. So basically UART consists of two modules, transmitter and receiver. We are going to explain about the transmitter module. Codes for the transmitter and receiver, both modules, will be set at the in the description. You can go through it and report us back if there is any query. Let's start. These are the standard libraries which are used for input, output and all definitions. Now this entity, we will first define the entity, which is the top level module. Here this is a generic, is one of the data types used in VHDL, which is basically used to describe any constant or value. So here generic one clock bit is defined, which is of integer type, and its value is initialized to 96. Basically this is used for as a baud rate for UART. If anyone of you has no idea of baud rate, kindly Google it. Now we will define the ports. We have clock, reset. This is the signal that transmit bytes will be starting, which is of 8 bit data, and this is the signal start bit, this is stop bit, this is the 8 bit data output which is transferred serially. This is the bit which becomes high when all the transmission is complete. Now let's start with the behavioral modeling. So first of all we will define the state types. Here we have states, namely idle state, start bit state, data bit state, stop bit state, clean state. Basically these start, data bit and stop bit, these all can be combined further as shifting. These state types are defined as signal, and we have clock counter for clock pulses, and we have bit index, which is basically which bit is being transferred, first, second, third and so on up to 8 bit. This is the again the signal for storing these 8 bit data. This is acknowledge that transmission is done. When all the 8 bits will be transferred, then it will become higher. This is the count. This is basically count for the clock divider. So basically clock divider is needed when we want to implement it on the FPGA as a hardware, and this is the clock divided. Now first of all we will see the code for the clock divider, which is the highlighted portion here. Input clock and reset are the inputs, and we will, if reset is 1, everything is initialized to 0, else if the rising edge of the clock, then counting will start at every clock pulse, and this value is changed according to the baud rate. So for demonstration we have taken it as 2500. Now for every 2500 pulses the clocks will be inverted. 2500 clock pulses of original clock will give rise to one clock pulse of this signal clock D. Now every further process of the UART transmission will take place in the clock D, on the clock D signal. So here we have, now we will start with the concept of FSM. This is the condition for starting of clock, is the rising edge. Now we will apply the case signal here, cases of all the states in the transmission module. So the first state is the idle state, which is by default initialized. In the idle state, if bit index and knowledge all are set to 0, count is also made 0. Now if this start bit is set to 1, then data which we have as 8 bit data, it is transferred to the temporary register which is declared above, and start bit is, the state is moved to start bit state. This means that first bit is being acknowledged here. Otherwise this start bit is not activated, the state will remain in the idle state only. Now this completes the first state. Now let's move to the second state, which is start bit. If start bit is there, then the initial data will all be remain 0, means no data is being transferred. Since we have 8 bit data, so we will count up to 7 for every bit. State remains at the start bit only till all the 8 bits are checked, and we will update the counter for every clock pulse. Otherwise this clock is not counted up to 8, then the transmission state will move to data bit. So now we will come to the third state, which is data bit. Now here we have to check all the 8 bit data which is coming serially, so which is basically bit by bit transfer from the temporary register to the output register, and every bit will be checked by a bit index number, and counter will be upgraded for every clock pulse, and this 8 state will remain in the state of data bit only until all the 8 bits are set. So here we have divided the clock counts as 16, because for first bit we will have, for start bit will take 8 bit data, then next 8 bit data will make the count as 16, then for third bit we will have 24, then for fourth bit we will have 32, and for fifth bit we will have 40, and so on. For 8 bit data we will move to this 48, 56, 64, and so on. So basically this state is the state which will convert all the 8 bits serially from input temporary register to the output register. Finally, in the stop bit register we have to again, it is similar to the start bit state, because here last counter is 96. We have taken some external values because we have to check for the stop bit also, so we have taken here as 96. The signal is 1. When the stop bit is being detected successfully, then transmission done acknowledge signal will be made high, that is 8 bit transmit successfully. Then the state will be changed to clean state, and clean state is just to assign the next state for as idle, that is the UART is ready to transmit next 8 byte of data. And for every other signals, the state is by default set to idle state. This completes all the cases and the FSM design for UART transmitter module. Now we will see the simulation part. So now I start with the simulation part of the transmitter module. So first we will see the implementation. This is the design. Select the implementation tab, and here for RTL view, so we will select the synthesize option, double click it. So when we will click this RTL schematic, and we will start with the top level block. So this is the designed UART module. Basically this is the top level entity. It will fix all the signals which we have defined in the entity block as input and output, and you can double click it to see the complete structure. You can see how many components are there. Basically this RTL view selects some of the basic gates and multiplexer and all sort of components for the design. See, this, these are all MUX, these are the D flip-flop and counters. So now let's move to the simulation part. Now so we will first check the syntax. Now the syntax is correct. Now click on this simulate behavioral model. So this iSim window will appear with all the signals and ports which we have defined. So this is the input clock, this is the reset, this is the 8 bit data which we have to transfer, this is the start bit, stop bit. So basically these all ports are depicted by I symbol, which are input which the user have to give. So first of all let's see about this clock divider. So here baud rate and this clock divider value, these are used for the FPGA implementation. So this depends on the FPGA board as well as the baud rate for which FSM is UART is being designed. So for implementation purpose it is set to a very high value, because UART has internal clock of internal crystal clock which is of the order of megahertz. So this value is quite high, and for simulation purpose we are making this value small, because we have to just demonstrate that the simulation which is being done here works on the divider clock. So now let's set all the input values. First of all, this is the original clock signal. We will define it with period of 1 microsecond. Then this is the reset. We will define it to 1 initially. This is the 8 bit data. We can set any value, 8 bit binary data. Then this is the start bit. We will make it to 1. This is the stop bit. We'll make it to 0. And then let's start. So when we are moving on the scale of microsecond, we will see that reset is 1, and so everything is undefined and the state is set to idle, and this clock delay signal has not been started because there is no clock divider signal here. So first we have to count up to 2500 for generating this signal. So we will make our reset back to zero. Then for simulation purpose we will move to 1000 step ahead. Now see, so see, we have clicked three times, that is 1000 1000 1000, that is 3000 approximately. So here first rising edge of the clock divider signal, this clock divider signal, it will again change the state to data bit. Now it will again compare each one bit state. Signal has not been transmitted because it have now just completed the start bit state, means that the module has checked that the start bit has arrived. Now next bit, whatever it is, it will come as data. So now as I will simulate, you will see that one by one bit from here, this data will be transferred to this serial variable. So for more clear vision, let's start to make it 8 times, that is 24. First bit of this data has been transferred for 8 clock pulse, means one bit data will be transferred for 8 clock pulse of this clock divider. Similarly for next we have this second bit data. So now my one simulation period of 24 millisecond will generate clock divider signal which is equivalent to 8 times the data. So now we have got the first two bits. Now let's see further, because as initially all the variables in the serial bit will be were zero, so for zero bit you will not be able to see this, but for one bits you will be able to differentiate the rate of transfer. Here we have completed the four bits data. Now see here, we have got 11001, 5 bit of data have been transmitted, and the state is continuously being transmitted as data bit states. Till all the 8 bits will be transferred, this state will remain here only. So now for next clock pulse we will get one more next data bit, that is 1. This 11 00 and 11, these bits have been transmitted, that is 6 bit of data has been transmitted. Similarly for further, for more clicks we will define, we will get two more zeros at the end. So here when the whole the data has been transferred, all the 8 bits, at next clock pulse of divider signal the state will be changed to stop bit for next 8 clock pulse of divider signal. So for after stop bit we will have one state for clean state, basically for removing all the registers back to zero, and the counter values are cleared at this clean state. We are ready for the next 8 bit data transmission.
Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel and keep supporting us.